dimmer, no matter how shiny the
I like listening
are.
To this,
Now,
overhearing
please.
This conversation.
Ignorance and facetiousness. That's all you people are good for. Shiny paint job indeed. You can't even imagine the Commonwealth's accomplishments.
You know, if you're so smart, maybe you could help us, hmm? But no, that never even crossed your mind. Go peddle your selfishness somewhere else.
Fine, but I'm not leaving. Not until I've spoken to Dr. Lee. I'll be here when she's ready to abandon her chemistry set and talk real science.
Suit yourself. Hey there.
I'm looking for my father. Is Dr. Lee as smart as they say she is?
She's certainly head and shoulders above most everyone else around here. Though, that's not saying much.
Man, her character model is kind of similar to Dr. Lee. Maybe she looks more lighter. Dr. Lee's kind of Asian, I guess. Can I get a drink around here, preferably somewhere clean?
The Weatherly Hotel is a good choice. It's on the upper deck.
Okay. That's it? I'm looking for my father.
Look, some of us are trying to get... Anybody coming through here would have to talk to the...
Yeah. She's not worth my time.
You there! What are you, some kind of lab assistant? No, you look a bit more weathered. Are you by any chance for hire?
Huh. That depends on what exactly you're talking about here. You have a problem with the way I look?
How amusing. You've mistaken my metaphor for a derogatory remark. I need a local, you see. Someone with verve. I've misplaced some very sensitive property.
Another side quest, huh? Missing property. What kind of property?
How do I... All you know of robots are those buckets of bolts. Those Mr. Handshakers and whatnot. Well, that's not all a robot can be. You see, in the Commonwealth, we've made artificial persons. Synthetic humanoids. Programmed to think...
That's real science compared to purifying water? Yeah, this guy's delusional.
Occasionally, they get confused and wander off.
Sounds like slavery to me. You sure they don't wander off on purpose? Interesting. But what's this got to do with me exactly? Enough technobabble, Jimmer. Just tell me what you want me to do. Sounds like slavery to me.
Nonsense. This is a machine we're talking about. Can you enslave a generator or a water purifier? Of course not.
Well, he gave the machine feelings and thoughts. Anyway, this is another philosophical realm that,
you are to find this missing android. I've tracked him to somewhere here in... He must have done something drastic, like facial surgery and a mind... It will be no easy task. He may not even realize he's an android.
I'll be compensated for my services, right? I'm not sure how it is up north, but around here we get paid for our work. Tell me, Zimmer, is your wallet as big as your mouth?
How quaint. Of course you'll be rewarded. I have at my disposal advanced technology from the Commonwealth. I'd be willing to share some of it with you. Just think, you'll be the envy of all your friends.
Sure, I'll look to find another Andrew for you so I got better things. You know what, let's try to do it.
Excellent. Here, listen to this message he sent me. He's mocking...
I need to know more about what I'm dealing with. What is an android exactly?
Forget everything you know about robots. Those buckets are mere children's toys compared to the real thing. Androids have fake skin and blood. And are programmed to simulate human behavior, like breathing. They can even eat and digest food realistically.
So any suggestions for finding this android?
Like I said, I suspect he's had facial reconstruction and possibly even a mind wipe. Search the offices of doctors or techies for android information. If he's come into contact with these people, there may be records. Start with Dr. Preston. He lives on
that's helpful.
Boat. See if he knows anything. He's a doctor, after all. Now, if you'll
Andrew wandered off. Why would he want a new mind and face?
Maybe he didn't exactly wander off. Maybe he fled. Escaped captivity, as it were, if he began to misinterpret his situation. It's possible my android sought to forget his previous life. Wipe away all memory, all guilt. Trick himself into believing he really is human.
So how the fuck does he defecate? His butt just opens up and just stuff just falls out?
Not human. No matter how badly he wishes it so. I made him. I want him. End of story.
I wonder for what purpose he's gonna use it for, like a sex toy or something? Well, I don't want to imagine that. Why would Andrew feel guilt? Come on, Zimmer. What aren't you telling me?
By God, you're as annoying as you are clever. Very well. I'll tell you what you want to know. The duty of this particular unit was the hunting and capturing of other escaped androids.
Ah.
Yes. It's one of the side effects of having such an advanced AI. Machines start to think for themselves. And so, this particular android may have believed he'd done something wrong, immoral, and wanted to forget those deeds. Satisfied now?
I see. Okay, so others have escaped. Why are you coming after this one? I understand. So tell me about the Commonwealth.
The Commonwealth itself is nothing but a war-ravaged quagmire of violence and despair. Inside the sealed environment of the Institute, however. But the Institute's affairs are none of your concern. Your undeveloped mind couldn't even begin to comprehend what we've accomplished.
Wow, such condescending remark. This guy's an asshole to a new degree. Do you know the history behind Rivet City?
Looks to me like a giant boat ran aground and a bunch of savages...
Wow, okay, so he's not interested. I have to go now. So, during the twice in a row now, in my quest for Rivet City's history, I've gotten my main quest done, and I got another side quest that's quite interesting. Talk to Armitage. So my search for Rivet City's history continues. So I snuck into Bannon's room, or what it seems like his room, yeah. Very easy lockpicking, so I lockpicked him. Anyway, he's a council member, so I think he knows the history of Rivet City.
And I are all on the council. We meet every Monday morning. I can be very influential, if you know what I mean. Far more than Seagrave Holmes.
Whoever Seagrave Holmes is, you think he's a threat to your influence?
A threat? No, of course not. He's a shady character. I just can't prove it. Now, if someone were to find something incriminating in his room...
Another
well,
side quest, huh?
Say I would be very appreciative.
I need you to prepare. Could I ask you about Rivet City's history?
Why, I practically set this whole place up. When I got here 12 years ago, it was just a handful of dead enders squatting in a rusted-out rowboat. Now I'm on the council, and with my leadership, we're the strongest settlement in the Wastes. Of course, a few of those dead enders still stick around, but we want to leave.
Speed. Hasn't Rivet City been around for longer than 12 years?
Well, yes, but it was hardly any place of importance until I arrived on the scene. That's all ancient history now. No one would ever care about it. If you insist on wasting your time on that, you could try that bartending old crone down below, Belle Bonnie.
Huh, bartending. Why are you guys living on this boat? I need to prepare my stuff. I have to go now. So we're in the city council.
Dr. Lee, Chief Harkness, and I are all on the council. I can be better.
Okay. Why are you leaving on this boat?
It's a place to live. With Dr. Lee on our side, maybe we can eat.
Yeah. He's not as helpful as I thought he'd be. But now I get to talk to a bartender, I guess. Okay, so I talked to everyone, pretty much, in the marketplace. Bannon was, like, the founder, I guess. And I talked to him. He wanted me to find incriminating evidence on Seagrave Holmes. I talked to Seagrave Holmes. Everyone is in the marketplace, and at daytime at least. After I talked to Seagrave Holmes, he mentioned about this Mr. Pinkerton and how he used to, you know a lot about the city, but he left. So I'm gonna go to his shed and find some evidence. So it's this way, I believe. Now that I'm wearing the radiation suit. Whoa, drink. I don't want to drink this water, actually. So, time to go to the Broken Bow. It's somewhere around here. Not quite sure exactly where I would find. But it's around here, Mr. Pinkerton's shop. Once I do that, I think I'll be able to... So, by talking to Seagrave Holmes, though, I believe most of... majority of my optional quest with the side quest was finished. So, I think I'll get done with this, and then I'll head back to Moira at Megaton City.